Red Baron Supreme going in. Starting to get really cold outside. I'm scared because I have holes all over my house. I don't have a heating system. All I have is a space heater, and it gets like 20 degrees. Sometimes zero. I'm scared. And I live through this every year. I freeze. Not even close to ready. It's almost ready. And cook the bottom. I do it this way every time. And the next person that makes fun of my dirty kitchen, I'm gonna beat the living crap out of you, okay? This is a stage set, you dumbass craps. It looks this way for a reason. It's not supposed to be clean, okay? It's a TV show, you dummies. Creeps. Kick your asses, creeps. I'll beat this chick. I'll beat up you so bad that you can't even get on your phone to call your parents. I'll beat up you. Wait. I need my Wando plate. You don't tell the Wando what to do. I'm my own boss. Nobody tells Wando what to do. Nobody! Because I'm the king of Wandoville. You think you're tough enough to mess with the wand? Go ahead. Try. Just one time, I was watching this movie, and it was about a kid that fell in love with this girl. And he had this other relationship with this unbeknownst person. And he was afraid to tell her about it. Until the end of the movie. And he ended up jumping off this bridge because he was so ashamed of what he had done. So anyway, the name of the movie was called Ode to Billy Joe, I think. And it starred Robbie Benson, who's a really nice guy and famous actor, really cool person. Robbie Benson was a very laid-back individual. Made some good movies. One movie was a gang movie where he got in gang fights. It was pretty good. I forget what it was called. Should probably Google Robbie Benson gang fight movie. Anyway, he starred in it with a bunch of bandoleros and stuff. And one time, when I was 18, I was watching the movie over at my best friend's house. And at the end of the film, when they beat the living crap out of them, my buddy's dad said, "You think some of them could have had enough respect to pull some punches?" No. That's probably true, but in a California Mexican gang, if you want to live another day, you do what you're told by the master. And that's all there is to it, basically. So, where is Robbie Benson today? He still looks like he's, you know, maybe 40. He looks really great. I think he probably never had a drink in his life or something. He did this one movie where he played this kid that did drugs. And I forget what it was called. But it was a Robbie Benson movie. And that. It had some pretty cool scenes in it. There was one scene where he was practicing basketball at school. And his coach didn't like him. So he had this one kid beat him up. Pretty cruel. And then he got in a fight with his dad. And after that, He made this secret compartment in his room where he could go in and do his drugs and listen to rock and roll music. Had all kinds of fancy lights and stuff in there where he could just chill and, you know, enjoy his drugs. And he did pills and everything. And one day, his dad found the secret compartment and went in there and killed him. And that was the end of the movie. And then Robbie Benson, he went on to make another film with this chick. And it was about skating. I don't know. After that, I don't remember what else he did. Well, he's starting some pretty big films. Name's Robbie Benson. Goodbye!